现在还是要为，在世界上有一些事情，我们为印度来祷告。
Let's pray for India right now。
这三年来，自从有印度教的强硬派执政之后。
This past few years, India was governed by the Hindu religion.
印度对少数宗教团体破坏增加很多。
So they have increased the persecution toward religious minorities.
在2017年，全国对基督徒的攻击就有400多件。
In 2017, the country attacked Christians about 400 times.
所以让我们一起举起祷告的手，求神在2018年给当地的基督徒力量和信心。
Let's raise our hands and pray for in 2018, give Christians in India more strength and faith.
在艰难的环境中，勇敢的为主做见证。
So they will become witnesses for Jesus in this difficult environment.
让印度有更多人来认识耶稣为救主。
So more people in India will come to know the Lord. Let's raise our hands.
我们一起来祷告。亲爱的父神。
Dear Heavenly Father, we pray for our brothers and sisters in India. We know that gospel is really rare in India. And we thank you that there's still people who want to come to know you.We pray for these brothers in Christ.
在这样艰难的环境中，他们仍然愿意为主来做见证。
In this difficult time, they still willing to become your witnesses.
恳求你的圣灵坚定他们的信心。
Pray that your spirit will strengthen their faith.
让不管什么样的环境临到的时候，主耶稣抓紧的是你的应许。
No matter what they face, they will hold on to your promise and blessing.
也让我们在世界各地的基督徒。
And that the whole world, the Christians in the world,
we will
pray for them,
为他们守望,
and watch for them.
主耶稣恳求你的圣灵真的是充满了印度。
Pray that your Holy Spirit will fill the country of India.
给当地的教会更多的信心与力量。
Give the local church more strength and faith.
感谢主耶稣。
Thank you, Jesus.
祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
Pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's
take a look at today's verse. Today's verse is in Ephesians chapter 4, 11 to 16.
有牧师和教师，为要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体，直得到我们众人在正道上同归于一，认识神的儿子得以长大成人，满有基督长成的身量，使我们不再做小孩子，中了人的诡计和欺骗的法术，被一切异教之风摇动，飘来飘去，就随从各样的异端。唯用爱心说诚实话，凡事长进，言语元首基督，全身都靠他联络得合适，百节各按各职，照着个体的功用彼此相助，便叫身体渐渐增长，在爱中建立自己。
Ephesians 4:11-16. So Christ Himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and teachers to equip His people for works of service.So that the body of Christ may be built up, until we all reach unity in the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Then we will no longer be infants, tossed back and forth by the waves, and blown here and there by every wind, of teaching and by cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. Instead, speak the truth in love.We will grow to become in every respect the mature body of Him who is the head, that is Christ. From Him, the whole body, joining and held together by every supporting ligaments, grows and builds itself up in love, as each part does its work.
愿神祝福他的话，我们现在请我们的牧师来证道。大家证道，题目是满有基督的生量。
Let's invite our pastor to give us a message. Today's message is attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ.
弟兄姐妹们，平安。
Peace, brothers and sisters.
今天是2018年的第一个主日。
Today is the first Sunday of 2018.
好不好，我们先跟前后左右弟兄姐妹彼此问安，说真高兴看到你，新年快乐。
Let's say to one another, Happy New Year. It's good to see you.
那今天我要跟弟兄姐妹分享的题目是满有基督长成的身量。
Today I'd like to share with you today's topic, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ.
那我们再来看一下我们教会。从2000年开始，这是我们 newborn baby 的时候，我们刚出生的时候，这是爱灵教会第一次复活节第一次聚会的时候。
Let's review our church history. We started in 2000, our church began in year 2000, Easter.
那个时候呢，我们家二儿子还在妈妈的腹中。
At that time, our younger son is still in the mother's womb. He was born on April the
30th.
One week later from the first service. And then here's a picture of the three-year anniversary. And then this is our six-year anniversary.
这是我们的十周年。
And this is our 10th year.
好，你可以看到上帝慢慢的在祝福，慢慢的在成长。生命也不能长太快了，长太快的话，你要很危险，对不对？
You can see that God is slowly growing our church.
然后到了第十年的四月四号，我记得那一天，我们的总会的议长来我们的教会说，鼓励我们要来建堂。
I remember 2010, in April, the head of the church, the EFC, he came and told us that to build our own church.
所以我们就认真来寻找，神就为我们预备了现在聚会的地方。
So God provided us as we seek Him, and God provided us this place.
好，这个是我们看到了，非常的喜欢这个地界。
We look at it and we like it a lot.
然后上帝就应许了我们，为我们预备了，我们就在四月开始买，结果我们这个十一月我们就买到，十二月十号我们就现堂感恩礼拜。
So we started in April that year, and by November, December, we were able to start our service here. That day we had about 500 people in this sanctuary. We saw God's grace, and then this is our 12th year.
这是我们的十六周年。
And this is our 16th year.
这是我们去年母亲节的团体照，十七周年。
And this is our last year, 2017 Mother's Day picture.
为什么要 review 这个呢？
Why do we need to review all this?
一方面我们数算主的恩典。
We need to count the Lord's blessing.
一方面我们谢谢神，在成长的过程当中会有高山，会有低谷。
We need to thank God that as we grow, we will face hills and valleys.
会有艰难，会有挑战，可是却也充满了恩典。
We face a lot of challenges, but we also receive a lot of grace.
但是感谢神，今年我们已经进入了什么？2018年了。
We thank you. We thank God that 2018 we're on the 18th year.
在美国，18岁的意义是什么？你们知道吗？
Do you know the importance of turning 18?
在美国， 十八岁是可以有选举权跟服兵役的。
So when you turn 18, you have the right to vote and to serve in military.
所以从十八岁开始，你已经是成人了。
So starting age 18, you are considered an adult.
当然要到二十一岁才能够喝酒。
Of course, when you turn 21, then you can drink.
所以十八岁对美国的年轻人，对美国人而言，它是一个成人的开始的标志。
Here in the United States, when you turn 18, this is a sign that you are an adult.
同样的，对爱灵教会而言，我们也几岁了？
Likewise, our church is turning 18 this year.
所以神也对我们众教众弟兄姐妹来说话，就是我们每一个人都要开始长大成人。
So God is at the same time telling us that everyone in our church needs to grow up and become an adult.
好吧，我们再来读一下第十三节。
Let's read verse 13.
一起读，请。只等到我们众人在正道上同归于一，认识神的儿子，得以长大成人，满有基督长成的身量。
Until we all reach unity in the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ.
所以你今天听到这个信息，神要对你说话，说你要长大成人。
As you listen to the message today, God is telling you that you need to become mature.
好不好？你跟旁边弟兄姐妹讲说，你要长大成人。
Tell the person next to you, you need to become mature.
好。那么，什么叫做长大成人呢？这里
What does it mean to become mature?
我们来看一下第十四节。
Let's take a look at verse 14.
这里我们也一起读，请使我们不再做小孩子。众的人的诡计和欺骗的法术，被一切异教之风摇动，飘来飘去，就随从各样的异端。
Then we will no longer be infants, tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming.
各位，什么叫长大成人？就是不要再做小孩子了。
What does it mean to become mature? This means to no longer be infants.
你在跟旁边的弟兄姐妹讲说，你不要再做小孩子了。
To the person next to you, no longer be infants.
各位，什么叫做小孩子？
What does it mean to be infants?
小孩子就是他会一直要，但是他不懂得给。
Infants, you see, infants, all they do is they want to take and receive, and never give.
小孩子最懂得歪理，都没有人来照顾我，我要。
They like to whine, and they keep saying, "I want more."
但是一个成熟的人，他会懂得给。
So a mature person will start giving.
他会懂得爱。
Will start loving.
小孩子会有很多的任性，会有很多的情绪。
You see a lot of the infants. They are very unreasonable. They are emotionally unstable.
小孩子有的时候他行为还是不合乎法规的。
A lot of their behaviors are incorrect.
但是我们看到一个成人、成熟的人，他处理事情是不一样的。
But you see a mature person, how he handles things is different.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们不要再做小孩子了。
So brothers and sisters, let's not be infants.
小孩子有的时候讲一次、讲两次、讲三次，还不一定听。
So if you even sometimes people tell you two or three times, you still don't listen.
但是大人我们讲一次就听了，对不对？
But if you're adult, you say one time, you listen.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们不要再做小孩子了。
So brothers and sisters, do not be infants.
那什么叫做不要做小孩子？小孩子呢，在他婴孩的时候呢，他会爱慕那纯净的灵奶。
So infants they like pure spiritual milk.
那弟兄姐妹，如果你的基督徒的生活都一直吃灵奶，可不可以
？So in your spiritual life, if you keep drinking spiritual milk, is that enough?
所以圣经里面告诉我们说，一个长大成人，他会懂得吃干粮。
So in the scripture, they tell us that if we are older, we can eat solid food.
我们来读一下希伯来书五章十四节。
Let's read Hebrews 5:14.
唯独一起读啊，听，唯独长大成人的才能吃干粮，他们的心窍习练的通达，就能分辨好歹。
Let's read together Hebrews 5:14. But solid food is for the mature, who by constant use have trained themselves to distinguish good from evil.
弟兄姐妹，很多时候小孩子是不懂得分辨好歹的。
Young children do not know how to distinguish good from evil.
可是圣经里面告诉我们，当你属灵的基督徒，一个长大成熟的基督徒，他懂得吃干粮，而且他懂得分辨好歹。
But the scripture says, one who's mature, eats solid food and is able to distinguish good from evil.
所以弟兄姐妹，不要再做小孩子，就是我们要开始吃干粮了。
So let's not be children and infants. Let's start eating solid food.
你知道？小孩子他那个食物有的时候因为他牙齿还没有发育好，所以有的时候小时候我们妈妈还会咬一咬，把食物咬碎了，然后给孩子吃。
You see some infants they don't have teeth, so mother will sometimes chew the food for the baby.
我们看到那个小鸟有没有？他们都妈妈咬碎然后吐给孩子吃，有没有
？You see like mother birds sometimes will feed the young birds with the
但如果一只鸟它已经长很大了，然后它还要妈妈给它吃，可以吗？像话吗
？Can you imagine a big mature bird still receives feeding from its mother？
你要能够懂得自己去找食物、找干粮，然后呢喂养自己，让自己的灵命来成长。
You have to know how to look for solid food and eat that so that you can become more mature。
你不能只靠一个主日的信息，这个主日的信息啊，我们当然是尽量预备非常好，但是还不够。
You cannot rely just on the Sunday message to feed you.
你想，你一个礼拜只吃一餐吗
？Do you only eat one meal a week?
不会吧？你每一天都要吃三餐。
Every day you eat three meals.
所以同样的，你的属灵的喂养也是要不断的自己来喂养自己。
Likewise, you need to continue feeding yourself.
那么一个，我们再看一个成人呢，不再做小孩子，他就不会中了人的诡计。
So you see that, if you're not infant, then you will not fall into the deceitful scheming.
你想想有哪一些人的诡计呢？
What kind of lies are out there?
我举两个例子。
Let's give two examples.
我记得我刚来美国的时候，那个时候，不太懂美国的情况。
So when I first came to the States, I didn't know about this.
结果我收到一封信。
So I received a letter.
我真的好高兴哦。
I was so happy.
你知道我中了100万。
It says I won $1 million.
真的，它上面写恭喜，我还看了，我英文不深哦，我就看了好仔细，我真的中了100万。
My English wasn't good, but it's pretty obvious on the envelope. It says I won $1 million.
你们怎么不恭喜我一下？
对不对？
对不对？结果，但是他有说100万可以，但是要先缴手续费。
But it says but you have to pay a application fee.
还有因为是在海外，还要付一个税。
Because it's also overseas, so you need to pay a special tax.
我忘记算一算，大概要付多少？搞不好要付个20,000多块。
I don't remember exactly how much, but it's probably like $20,000 of processing and application.
各位，你觉得值不值得
？Do you think it's worth it?
我付27,000，我就能够拿到100万，你要不要嘛
？You pay $20,000, but you can receive $1 million. Is that? Yeah.
用27,000换100万美金，要的举手。你看这些小孩子。
So these kids are very smart. They will change $20,000 for million.
我最喜欢跟律师讲到，因为他们配合度好高。
I like to appreciate the lawyers because they're very cooperative.
还好我没有中计。
Thank God I didn't fall into that trap.
我若真的汇了两万七过去，那一百万是十成什么？
啊。If I send that money, there's no way I'll be seeing the winning that the promise.
以后我在带年轻人的时候。
So later on when I led a youth group.
真的有一个年轻人偷偷来跟我讲。
It was a youth member.
他说刘哥，有一件事我可以讲，但你不要告诉别人。
He came to tell me that Brother Leo, I want to tell you something, but please don't tell anybody else.
说好，真是。
What?
他说，我中了
100万。I won $1 million.
好，刘哥，我拿到这100万以后呢，我飞你给你。
He said, once I receive this $1 million, I'll give you some.
心里也在想，而且他真的信以为真哦。
So this younger brother actually think this is real.
各位，这是什么的诡计？人的什么？人的诡计？你告诉旁边的。
This is a type of deceitful scheming.
年轻人啊，千万不要相信啊。
Young people, please don't believe that.
然后又有什么人的诡计呢
？So what other things are in our lives?
有一次我早上凌晨五点起床。
One day, I woke up at 5 a.m.
我看到一个 email 上面写的我一个好朋友寄来说他在摩洛哥旅游，结果钱包被偷了。
So I saw an email from a friend saying that he's in Morocco.And his purse was stolen.
就他现在没有钱付那个旅馆费，看我能不能现在赶快汇一点钱给他付旅馆费。
So he cannot pay for his hotel bill, so he asked me to transfer some money to him so he can pay.
如果是你的话，你会不会急啊？你的好朋友呢？
So if it's you, would you be worried because this is your good friend?
还好，我真的我要打电话查证一下，我就打他的手机试试看。
So I want to make sure, so I call his cell phone to make sure.
凌晨五点啊。
5 a.m.
他从床上起来接。
So he woke up from his bed.
哦，我没有去旅游，我现在还在睡觉。
He said, I didn't go travel. I'm still in my bed.
但谢谢你，我今天早上已经接了10通电话。
Oh, but thank you. I received 10 phone calls this morning.
哪一天你早上接到电话，人家一直打来，你怎么了？你怎么你就知道你的邮件被什么 ？Hi.
So if somebody keep calling you in the morning, so you, that means your email probably hacked.
我们当中有一对夫妻，他的朋友也接到诈骗的电话。
So a friend's wife also received a phone call.Phone scam.
跟他说，他需要急需要80,000块。
The phone scam told her that they need an emergency $80,000.
人民币。结果那个朋友为了他，真的就汇了80,000块给对方。
So she actually wired $80,000.
结果他才问他说，那你想一想，打电话说你在哪里，你还好吗
？And then she called and find out her friend is doing okay.
结果根本没事，结果被骗了80,000块。
But nothing happened. So that meant they were robbed of $80,000.
对，好不好？你跟旁边人讲，小心中的人的诡计。
So tell other people be careful of schemes.
不仅有的时候有人的诡计，小心有的时候也会有一些谣言、谎言。
Not only deceitful schemes, but also rumors.
弟兄姐妹，这里英文是这样写的：谣言啊，是带着恨来的。
It says the rumors are carried by haters.
然后呢，是被愚笨的人去传播的。
Spread by fools，
然后是被这个一点啊，这个中文翻译应该是啊，谢谢主持人啊，对，啊是白痴的人接受的
，accepted by idiots。
所以各位弟兄姐妹，有的时候有很多人的诡计，我们要小心。
So be careful of these rumors and lies.
好，然后也停止一些谣言跟传言。
So we are responsible to stop some rumors.
我们可以，如果有必要，你可以找当事人去证实。
If necessary, talk to the person to find out if it's true.
所以我们不再做小孩子了 ，Amen.
Let's not be infants.
啊，如果你是小孩子，你就会很容易听信一些谣言啊，诡计。
So if you are an infant, then you're easily swayed by rumors.
但如果你不是小孩子，你就很成熟，你就懂得来分辨好歹。
If you are mature, then you can distinguish good from evil.
还有，小孩子也，这里就说，小孩子也很容易会中欺骗的法术。
So it says that children are very easily deceived.
什么叫欺骗法术呢？有一个欧洲有一个龙国叫做万家。
So there is this famous blind woman in Europe. Her name is Baba Vanga.
听说她预言911成真呢。
So they say she prophesied 9/11.
结果那一年美国总统的时候，他就预言说奥巴马会是美国的最后一任总统，然后希拉瑞会因为生病而退选。
So she once prophesied that Obama would be the last U.S. president, and Hillary would get really sick and drop out from election.
结果这样的预言，这样的骗术有没有成功？
Did this come to true?
没有。
No.
所以弟兄姐妹，你们要小心，这个坊间哦，还有很多的。这个塔罗牌有没有玩过
？In our society, there's also other things such as tarot cards.
有没有人摸过这个塔罗牌？玩过、看过那个标志？啊，怎么样
？Anybody play with tarot cards？
Judge 也玩过，好，看过了哈、哦。对，好，有没有人去看过这个手相？你知道这个我们罗伦泰的罗卡勒斯那边就有一小间了，怎么样？有没有去？
Anybody know the fortune teller? Just why you roll the heights.
你不用去找他，找他还要钱，牧师帮你看就好了。
Don't go to them. Come to me.
以前我们要追师母的时候，都说：“哎，来，我帮你看一下手相。
”So before when I was dating.
这个是事业线。
I can tell of hands.
这是爱情线。这是生命线，会不会啊？懂不懂啊？那么师母呢，命中就会注定有遇到一个人来爱她，对。
So in my wife's hand, this person will come to love her.
Okay, 啊，找那边还要交钱啊，找牧师不用钱啊，帮你看。各位，这些都骗人的。
This is all deceitful schemes.
对，啊，还有什么占星术
？And other such as astrology.
有的时候我们都很喜欢问说，哎，请问你是几月生的
？A lot of time we like to ask, when are you born?
你是什么星座
？What is your sign?
你们知道牧师是八月十号生的。
So you know that my birthday is August 10th.
有没有谁知道八月十号是什么座？哇，你们很熟哎、
欸。Anybody knows what sign that is? Oh, you guys are really good at this.
哎，我以前也很相信这个、欸。
Before I used to believe in this.
结果我发现，啊，这些都可以废掉，只要我们按着真理而活就够了。
So all this is unnecessary as long as we live by the truth.
Amen.
Amen.
好，所以弟兄姐妹，你去知道哦，你是双鱼座的，你是天蝎座的，哦，你是某某星座的，哦，你的个性应该是这样子，结果你就被这个套住了。
A lot of times we are trapped by the signs that we label people with.
所以，那你就问说，那牧师，我们要如何才能够满有基督长成的身量呢
？How do we become mature?
那么，这是我们今年一整年要讲的题目。
This is our goal for this entire year.
但我们现在简单的把这四大点讲一下。
So we want to give you a summary of this year.
第一个最重要就是要成全圣徒，各尽其职。
The first part is to equip these people for works of service.
我们再来读一下十一节好吗？
Let's read verse 11.
行。他所侍的有使徒，有先知，有传福音的，有牧师和教师。
So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, evangelists, the pastors, and teachers.
为要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体。
To equip his people for works of service so that the body of Christ may be built up.
等一下我们就要同工就职。
Later on, we're going to have inauguration of deacons.
我们当中有很多人有不同的恩赐。
So within us, we have a lot of spiritual gifts.
而这些恩赐就是彼此放在一起的时候，彼此来成全。
So we put all these gifts together so we can support each other, build up each other.
那么刚刚讲的这个五重的指示，我们来记一下。
Let's memorize these five works of service.
你知道什么叫使徒？使徒就是能够开展一个事工。
So do you know what apostle can start a ministry?
所以一般我们是让他做大拇指。
So we let the apostle be the star.
那么什么叫先知？先知就是哈指着人骂人的，有没有？按着圣经的真理来骂人，所以先知有没有
？So prophets are for rebuking, so they are prophets.
好，那么中间这个中指是最长的，对不对？他的脚最长，所以他要传福音。
So, in the middle, we have the evangelist. It's the longest finger, so he's there to preach the gospel.
那你告诉我，什么时候你的结婚的时候，你的戒指戴在哪一个手指上面？
You know, your ring finger is for marriage.
戴在哪一个手指？左手的吗？ Yeah. 无名指有没有？
Wedding,
这是牧师嘛？
Wedding,
有没有？
Wedding,
牧师帮你证婚啊？有没有？
So pastor, his role is for that.
好，那。教师就是要让人家洗耳恭听，有没有？耳朵要清干净啊，让人家洗耳恭听，所以是教师最小的。
So teacher is the pinky finger, and you can clean your ear with that.
好，你记起来了吗？你现在眼睛闭起来一下。
So close your eyes.
好，大拇指是什么？使徒。再来，指着人去教导的是什么？先知。再来，中间那个最长的是传福音。再来，谁把戒指戴在你的牧师？再来，教师怎么样？哎，这样记起来怎么样
？So have you memorized this？
牧师以前是开补习班的。
So I used to open a cram school。
我们都用最简单的方式让大家记起来。
I used the easiest way for people to remember things。
对，好，所以你记起来，以后我们再来讲。
Later on, we'll talk about this more.
那么，所以呢，教会要怎么样让大家能够满有基督长成的身量呢
？So how do we let people have attaining the fullness of Christ？
就是发挥神在我们身上的每一份，然后呢，大家彼此建造起来。
It's to individually fulfill your service so that we can build up together.
那么第二点呢，就是要认识神的儿子。
So the second point is to know the Son of God.
我们一起来读一下第十三节，请。只等到我们众人在正道上同归于一，认识神的儿子，得以长大成人，满有基督长成的身量。
Until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measures of the fullness of Christ.
是啊，在教会里面最重要的一件事情就是来认识主耶稣。
The most important thing, when you go to church, is to know the Son of God.
而且认识主耶稣的公义，认识主耶稣的慈爱，认识主耶稣的牺牲，认识主耶稣的救赎。
To know His righteousness, His love, His salvation.He sacrificed.
认识他的怜悯，认识他的恩慈，哦，认识他的
圣。To know his mercy, to know his kindness, to know his just.
然后把基督的性情进入到我们的里面，然后我们有基督的样式。
So you can take on his life into your life.
所以你来到教会最重要的一件事情就是 认识神的儿子。
So the most important thing is to know God's Son.
唯有让神的儿子在你的里面一直一直的丰满起来，你才会满有基督长成的身量。
It's to let His life grow in yourself, so one day you have the whole measure of the fullness of Christ.
好不好？也跟旁边弟兄姐妹讲，你要来认识神的儿子。
So tell the person next to you, you need to come to know God's Son.
那么第三大点是讲到我们要用爱心来说诚实话。
The third important thing is to speak the truth in love.
好，那么什么叫爱心说诚实话呢？有的时候我们很有爱，我们很想要说诚实话，可是我们没有爱心。
How do we speak the truth in love? A lot of time we want to speak the truth, but we don't have enough love.
所以有的时候我们要来想一想，在讲话之前我们要先想一下。
So before we speak, we need to think about it.
这里有说 T-H-I-N-K.
So here says think, T-H-I-N-K.
T 就是 true.
T stands for truth.
就是说，你说的这些话都是真的吗？
Does it mean everything you say is true?
好，再来 ，H 是什么？是 helpful， 是有没有？你说这些对大家有帮助吗？
What are you saying? Is it helpful?
好，再来 I inspiration， 就是说你说这些会激励人吗？鼓励人吗？
Do you say these things to inspire?
对。Necessary 就是说你有必要说这些话吗？
N stands for necessary. Is it necessary to tell them?
对。K 是 kind， 就是你说这些话厚道吗？
Are you kind with your when you talk to people?
对。那么弟兄姐妹，我们要用爱心说诚实话之前要先想一下。
So if you want to speak the truth in love, you have to think.
你要按照这五个步骤来想。
You have to follow these five rules.
同时呢，这里也讲到说，你要用爱心说诚实话之前，第一个，你还要抑制一下自己。
So before you speak the truth in love, you have to restrain yourself first.
有可能你里面那个太冲动了。
Maybe you're being too rash.
还有你要思想这个时机是合适的吗？
You still need to check the moment is correct.
有时候我们弟兄姐妹还在忙，还在路上，哎，某某人，你过来一下，我跟你讲一下，有一件事情我一定要跟你讲。
A lot of time you run into people, you want to say things in a hurry.
也许这不是对的时机。
Maybe that's not the right moment.
还有你要 check 一下你自己，你的心是不是纯正的？
You have to check yourself and see if your heart is right.
还有再来，你要 check 一下你们的关系到底够不够。
You need to check your relationship with that person.
有的时候我们交浅言深呢。
A lot of times, our relationship is really shallow. We speak really, really harsh.
平常你又没有来爱他、关心他，平常你又没有跟他建立爱的、信任的关系。
A lot of times we don't have that relationship before we speak.
然后我们就要去，就以为你跟他关系够，然后要跟他讲真话。
And then you want to tell them the truth.
这里又说，还有你要 check 你要说的话语。
And you have to check the words that you use.
你的话语是不是带着恩慈跟智慧
？Does it come with kindness and wisdom?
所以这个以后我们都还会再讲。今天只是好像给你们开胃菜一样。
Today is just an appetizer, a preview. We will go into this more.
用爱心说诚实话，我们要讲一个 quarter.
So, just about speaking the truth in love, we will spend an entire quarter on this.
再来第四大点是联络合适，彼此相助。
Fourthly, we need to join and be held together by every support team leader.
十六节，我们一起读一下吧。请全身都靠他联络的合适，百节各按各职，照着个体的功用彼此相助，便叫身体渐渐增长，在爱中建立自己。
So, verse 16, from him the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love, as each part does its work.
弟兄姐妹，你要知道，基督徒你没有办法单独的存在。
You know, as Christians, we cannot live by ourselves.
我们每一个人都需要彼此相助，每一个人都需要连接在一起，你的生命才会成长。
We have to help each other. We have to be connected so that we can grow together.
所以基督徒是活在群体里面的。
So we are a group.
有些弟兄姐妹，他可能在家里面看一点基督教电台，他以为这样子就能够有生命的成长。
Some Christians think they can stay home and just watch some Christian television and they can grow that way.
有的人他来主日聚完会就走，他都不参加小家，也不参加跟人的爱的关系。
Some people they just come for the Sunday service, but they just leave right away and do not join the small group.
这样的生命是没有办法操练的。
Your life will not grow if you do that.
你必须要在这个团队当中，你会有摩擦。
You must stay in the group, so there will be some friction.
你会有发现对方跟你不同。
You will realize your differences between you.
你会有发现有些人想法意见跟你不一样。
You will notice that some people have different opinions.
可是就在这个过程当中，我们操练谦卑。
But within this group, we will learn to humble ourselves.
我们操练接纳。
We learn to accept one another.
结果我们的生命就蛮有基督长成的身量。
In that way, slowly our body would become more and more Christ-like.
有的时候我们也需要等候。
Sometimes we have to spend time in waiting.
有时候你会发现这个人怎么个性这个样子。
Sometimes you will think that, oh, why is this guy like this?
结果经过几年以后，他的生命改变了。
But after a few years, you see his life changed.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们需要活在群体里。
So, brothers and sisters, we must live in a group.
感谢神的恩典，我们现在要来举行同工就职典礼。
We thank the Lord that today we also have the co-worker inauguration.
我们这每一个同工都是教会的肢体。
All the co-workers are.
我们请所有的同工在周报上面的同工到前面来。
If your name is on the program, please, your co-worker, please come forward.
包括 youth,
including youth co-workers.
我们有牧养的同工。有行政的同工，有长职，还有幼师，我们都排一排好吗？
We have co-worker in different areas such as administration, youth, pastoring.
好，稍微挤一点啊，在那边再挤一点，大家。再过去一点，这边还站不完。对，感谢神，还可以吗？再请一下，再请一下，再请一下。好，这些同工都是有不同的恩赐。
These co-workers, they have different spiritual gifts.
他们。要彼此连接在一起，来建立基督的身体。
They are joined together to become Christ's body.
所以，2018年的同工，我们现在有一个誓约。
So now we're gonna have them say the pledge of co-workers for this year.
我们还是，又是 sorry， 我们没有English 翻译，要 translate。那你们勇敢，你们就 believe 就好了。Say yes. 好，但是还是有缺失。好，你们要领受长职同工的职务，你们是否确信这是神的呼召？我们先注意。
So right now, the question is, you are to receive the assignment of co-worker. Do you believe this is God's calling?
是不是？
是
好，你们愿意担任爱琳台福基督教会的同工？
So you're willing to become the co-worker for this church?
是要忠诚尽职，谦卑服侍，顺服，协助牧师，同心合一，兴旺福音。
So you are to be faithful in your position, to humble and be obedient, and help the pastor and work together for the gospel.
来荣耀神，侍奉他的教会。
To glorify God and serve His church.
你们是否愿意这样做
？Are you willing?
Yes.
Yeah. 教会的头是耶稣基督。
The head of the church is Jesus Christ.
教会中高举基督为主。
The church raised Jesus as the Lord.
凡是关于教会的事务，要依靠他来处理。
So everything at church, we rely on Him.
你们是否愿意如此行
？Are you willing to do that?
是。
谢神。好，那么我们会员也要誓约，请起立。
So let's have all the church members stand up.
兄姐妹，这是互相的。他们要做教会的仆人，要做教会的领袖。同样的，我们的做弟兄姐妹的会员的，我们也愿意来支持他们，帮助他们。所以这里也有三个问话。
So there's three questions we need also ask the members.
我们也可以大声的回答。
Please respond.
对，你们已经选他们做你们的同工，你们是否诚心实意接纳他们？
They are your co-workers. Are you willing to accept them?
是不是？
是。
好，他们为你们办理教会的事，你们应当敬尊重他们。
So they do a lot of work for the church, so you have to respect them.
敬爱他们，体贴他们，协助他们，常常为他们祷告。
You will honor them, be kind to them, and help them, and also pray for them frequently.
你们是否愿意这样行
？Are you willing？
是不是？好。第三，关于维持教会的秩序。
About church rules。
若彼此有过失、争执或误会。
So if there's any conflicts or misunderstanding，
应该禀请牧师与同工会来处理。
You will allow the pastor。And the co-worker to handle this.
不可到处散播宣扬，以致影响教会的声誉。
You will not spread rumors and dishonor the church.
你们愿意这样遵行吗
？Are you willing?
是不是？
是。
好，感谢神。OK.
Thank you.
我现在邀请所有的同工来到台前，我们跪在神的面前。我也邀请我们所有的会员举手来为他们来祷告。求神给他们有智慧，有从神而来的力量，而且是圣洁的，是谦卑的，来服侍。在2018年的时候，有神的能力能够来服侍他的教会，让教会越发的兴旺起来。
Let's have the co-workers kneel in the front and have all the members raise your hands to pray for the co-workers that they will do a good job to glorify.
好，面向
前。Church.
那我需要有人来弹琴，几点在吗？好，好不好？我们会员们、弟兄姐妹们，我们也举起祷告的手来为他们来祷告。之后，我要邀请我们新任的主席查理来祷告。
Let's raise our hands and pray for our co-worker, and then I'll ask Charlie, our new presider, to the new chairperson, Charlie, to pray for us.
我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
哈利路亚，主耶稣，我们赞美你的恩典，圣灵你在我们的当中来运行。主，谢谢你，你拣选这一批这么美好的同工团队。主啊，我们当中有长职，哦，主啊，有小家长，有部门同工，有区长，哦，主耶稣，主啊，有幼师的年轻人，哦，主耶稣，主啊，我们有各司其职，好像一个身体连接在一起。要来服侍你，要来得着这个社区的百姓，要来赢得你许多的灵魂。阿爸父，你使用爱灵教会的每一个同工，使用跪在你面前的弟兄姐妹，每一位都是你所喜悦的，每一位都自洁在你的面前，每一位都能够，哦主啊， 谦卑、忠心、良善，主啊，来被你主你所使用，主啊，破碎我们，让我们更加知道我们是无有的，我们是哦，主啊，卑贱的，我们是不足的。但是主，因着基督在我们的里面，我们就蛮有能力，蛮有恩高。谢谢主的恩典，使用我们，听我们的恳求，奉耶稣的名。哎，我要请我们的新任的主席查理·庄玉礼执事来代表所有的同工会做一个在神面前的恳切的祷告，委身的祷告。
爱我们的父神，这是何等荣美的一刻！主耶稣，你呼召这些的弟兄姐妹来到你面前来服侍你的教会。主耶稣，我们就恳求你的圣灵浇灌，让我们随时来记得主耶稣你的教诲。你的爱是何等的长阔高深，你是这样将我们从罪人中拣选出来，所以我们有这样的福分来服侍，来荣耀你的国度。主耶稣，我知道很多时候我们会有软弱，我们会有困难，但是主耶稣，奉你的名，主耶稣，我们要胜过一切。谢谢你让我们在2018年有这么多的弟兄姐妹愿意来，将他们生命交托在你面前，来服侍你，来服侍众位弟兄姐妹。恳求你的圣灵带领，使我们能够在你里面守节心清的来服侍你。主耶稣也真的是带领我们，使我们能够将主你的教训，就是那坐在最小的弟兄身上，就像是坐在主耶稣的身上。主耶稣，就求你真的是带领。让我们真的是谦卑，满有主耶稣你的身量来服侍你。求你真的是继续的祝福爱你教会，在2018年，主耶稣，我们站立在这里，为的是要传扬你的福音。主耶稣，我们为的是要让更多的灵魂得救，而不是要来荣耀我们个人的能力、我们的才能。是的，耶稣，谢谢你，你的爱来抚慰我们每一个人。没有你的爱，这一切都是枉然的。我们就在你面前，跪在你面前，来领受这美好的福分。愿服侍你是甘甜，服侍你是我们的家庭，是我们的个人，是我们所有的一切，主耶稣得到更多的祝福。谢谢主耶稣，将各位每一位同工都交托在你面前，求你继续来带领我们奔跑前面的道路。感谢主，这样子祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
我们会员请坐，我们也拍手，谢谢这些同工。好，现在邀请我们的新任主席来介绍我们这2018年的同工们。
We're going to ask the new chairperson this year to introduce our co-workers.
那容许牧师先来介绍我们今年的2018年的新任主席是庄玉礼执事 Charlie 庄，我们拍手。
我来这边介绍每一个部门的同工，还有我们先介绍，我用这个周报的上面的那个顺序来介绍好了。因为周报上面真的是地图比较小，现在老花看不到，所以照相在手机上。OK， 副主席是我们的国政，
谢谢。
再来就是我们的周长老宣教，
我们一般的。
那在我们教会里面，在同一个岗位上面服侍最久的，大概就是我们周长老。那他非常辛苦，担任我们教会这么多年来的主席。那今年就是让他休息，然后呢，然后让他真的是在神里面有更多的领受。好，然后再来就是我们的 Alan。他是负责我们的儿童跟休赛，所以呢，很多时候我们是一些这些什么电力的那个维修啦，然后最近我们 教会前面的那个厕所堵塞的问题终于得到解决。我们把全部的那个 concrete 全部开了，全部把那个旧的那个那些管道全部都换掉，所有的东西都是他在负责的，所以非常谢谢他。然后呢，再来就是我们的 Robert 灵修跟总务，还有我们就只是负责关怀招待，还有电脑资料管理。OK， 再来介绍我们部门同工哈，我们的儿童事工的主任是人类，主任是我们的婷宇跟 Joanne， 站出来，在哪里？站出来，好，然后再来是我们的儿童事工的同工，是我们的 Vincent 跟 Cozy。再来是灵修营的主席，是我们的 Jason。然后我们有新的敬拜团长，就是我们的 Gabriel 吴蒙明。谢谢我们的敬拜团的团长。然后副团长是我们的 Maggie。Maggie 也是做好久的敬拜团的团长。然后再来就是诗班的班长 Rachel 现在还在香港准备他的婚礼。对，然后有现在是指挥是我们的基甸。然后膳食方面是我们的 Gary。影音是 Andrew， 那人在现在在台湾哦。然后再来是财务，是我们的 Winnie 跟慧娟。然后那个再来是会计是 Joanne。许同芳还有 Christina， 然后再来是祷告部，是我们的 Scott 跟 Lisa， 然后还有我们的灵修是我们的 April， 然后新人关怀是我们的 Ken。Ken 现在还在大陆，还没有回来，不过感谢主。然后还有我们的雅歌区长是 Margaret。 再来我要介绍小家长，芥菜中小家的小家长是国政。然后嘉安小家是东瑶兄。然后活水小家是 Robert。夫妇他们的家人在台湾，爸爸他们在台湾。然后光彦小家是国宾，那国宾要出差，那恭喜帮忙回水一下。然后喜乐小家是九二年，喜鹊，喜鹊，对，真的是老爸爸，喜鹊
要拜他吗？
下一个才是喜乐小家。
我可不可以邀请那个 Amy 也来到前面吗？代替 Ken，
代替 Ken，
你是夫妻是吗？没有没有。Amy， 对对。
好，就是 Ken， 其实 Ken 跟 Amy 一起在待哈。对。然后再来是恩福小家，是 Victor 兄。然后一泽信小家是 Key， 现在一样跟对人在香港。然后丰收小家是 William。 OK， 然后再来是信望爱小家是我们立明兄跟白姐。舞蹈是 William， 他也在后面，然后 Joshua、Agnes、Susanna， right？ 然后英文的青年的部分，身穿的童工有Caleb。周间很多学校有这些问题啊，什么的时候，他有时候都跟我们讲到，他都会帮很多很多的忙，非常谢谢他。好，还有吗？暂时没有，都起来。
对，好，好，我们邀请那个师母一起上来，我们一起来照张相，好不好？好，来这里照，来这里，来这里，来这里。